just love it. I just love it. I just love it. I tell you what, I just love it if it went there and got the result. I just love it.
You know, I'm not going to ask you how his training's gone. His training's never easy, as we know. But there's just something about you, a look in your eye. Obviously, you look fit, that goes without saying. But I've watched you train for fights before, John, and I could sense something's different here.
Yeah, obviously, with being a world title fight, it always gives you that little bit of extra motivation. And this is challenging for the world title. This is something I've dreamed of since, you know, I first put on the gloves. And yeah, there has been a little bit of an edge to me in this training camp, and I'm enjoying boxing. And I'm just really looking forward to getting over there and putting on a great show.
That world title, you've been chasing it many years. The Rios fight is the one you wanted all along, you know, for a few years now. It's finally here, you know, is it out of the blue for you?
Yeah, especially after losing last time against Kevin. I didn't expect to be in no man's land for a bit. I didn't know where my career would be going, but, you know, this opportunity has presented itself. And yeah, we took it with both hands. I got for the fight, and yeah, it's a fight I definitely wanted. And challenging for the world title in hopefully Maddison Square Garden, it's a fight that I've dreamed of, and I'm really confident I can go over there and win this fight. And I know a lot of people are writing me off already, and judging off the performance against the Mitchell fight last time. But you know, people learn from the mistakes, and I've watched that Mitchell fight back, and I've looked at the mistakes I've made, and the way I was cutting corners in training camps, you know, in the run-up to that fight and previous fights. And, you know, me and Joe, we've had our fallout, and we've made up after it. And there's a lot of things in and outside the ring that I've put right for this fight. And, I just really feel like I've got my old self back, and training's gone really well. And I just can't wait to get in there, and for me and Joe to go over there and finish what we started, win a world title. I think it's going to be a great experience for both of us. People deal with losses in different ways. I think the loss to the Mitchell fight was a good chance for me to take a long hard look at myself and look at how I was living my life inside and outside of the ring. And I've gone away from Joe, we've had a fallout, and I've had a chance to just look at myself and put things right. I've sorted my life out outside the ring, and I'm, you know, just got myself sorted and got myself in a happy place, and I've got myself in a good place as well inside training. And you know, in this training camp since I've been back with Joe, it's the most I've enjoyed boxing training for about four years. And we've been looking at myself in sparring and the way I'm training in camp, and you know, it couldn't be going better. Really sharp, really, really loving boxing again. And it used to be I'd be in training for fights, and I'll be counting down the weeks thinking another 3-4 weeks and I'll be out on the piss with my mates, another 3-2 weeks and I'll be out on the piss. Whereas this fight, it's not been like that. I've been in training now for 10-12 weeks, and I've not been counting down the weeks looking forward to getting back on the piss with my mates. I've just been enjoying boxing and really getting into it and getting back to my old self. And I am a dedicated trainer, but I just maybe lost my way a little bit over the last couple of years and couple of fights. And it's just that loss is, like I say, it can be a blessing in disguise, and I think it has been for me. I think it's been a good wake-up call, and I'm just really looking forward to getting into this fight against Brandon Rios. I know I'm more than capable of winning the fight, and I really want to go over there and shock the world.
You've got that 0-1 record now. You know, you're not holding on to that anymore. You're the underdog in this fight. You know, but when you are, you know, the underdog and written off, is that when John Murray is dangerous?
Definitely. I think anyone, you put them in a corner and you back them up against the wall, you get to see what they're really made of. And I think there's been times in my career where I have been the underdog going into fights, and I think some of them times have been my best performances. And going over to America and fighting on big shows is something that I am used to. I've done it before. I boxed on a Delahoye May with an undercard. I boxed on Ricky Atame with an undercard. I boxed on the undercard of Jeff Lacy against Robin Reed in front of 14,000 in Florida. You know, I have travelled and fought before, and it's something that I am used to, and I think them big experiences are going to stand me in good stead going over there and fighting for this world title. I mean, I'm not going to go over there and be shot and then overawed by the experience of it all. I'm there to do a job, and I've had a really good camp, and I feel within myself mentally I'm prepared, physically I'm prepared. I just want to go over there and do the business.
There's no doubt, you know, the Mitchell fight, massive fight for you, for Kevin, for Britain. But leading up to that, did you take your eye off the ball? Was you just going through the motions?
I think so. I think I got stuck in this rut of fighting a certain way of thinking I just had to turn up and I'd be too strong for my opponents. I'd be able to walk in behind a tight guard, tire my opponents out, and then eventually get on top of him and go through him. And it's just down to myself and just got used to fighting a certain way and stopped using my boxing brain a bit. And things happen for a reason. I think. You know, that loss to the Mitchell fight was a good kick up the arse, what I needed, a good, you know, kick up the backside, and it made me look at myself and, you know, areas where I thought I might have been training hard. I've looked back and thought, well, maybe I wasn't training too hard and maybe I was cutting corners in training, and, things happen for a reason, and that loss against the Mitchell fight, I think, has been a good wake-up call for me, and it's come at the right time, because maybe if I'd won that Mitchell fight, if I'd gone on and won the fight, then I wouldn't have sorted myself out, and by the time this world title challenge came, when it really mattered, I would have got beat. And like I say, it's happened. It's given me a wake up call, and I've tried to put things right for this fight. And you know, I think I've given myself a really good chance of going over there and winning this fight.
I don't know what you think, John, but looking around, there's not an awful lot of press coverage on this fight, and any that there is, and views that you read of people, a lot of people are writing you off. Have they forgot, you know, how good John Murray is?
Yeah, I think so. It doesn't bother me too much. There hasn't been a lot of press or, you know, reviews or build up to the fight, because, like I say, I've just been doing my own thing. My whole career, I've just done my own thing, gone under the radar and just gone about my business the way that I do. And it's no different from this fight. I've just got my head down, got into training, and obviously after getting beat last time, I've not expected it. I'd be a big you know, show about me fighting for the world title because I just got beat, but, you know, I've just gone about my business like the way I do, and I'm expecting to go over there, put on a great show, and then once I do the business, I'm expecting a lot of coverage.
It might be a good thing that it's not slipping under the radar.
Like I say, go under the radar, do my business, and a little bit like when Mr. T fought Rocky Balboa the first time. He's just in the camp training hard, and Rocky Balboa was going about his business, you know, enjoying the showmanship of it all, and he took his eye off the ball, and we think Brandon Rios might be doing that, and I'm Mr. C this time, and I'm going to go over there and do the business.
I'm looking at a John Murray who was, you know, in them old days, dedicated, loved, eat, slept, drank boxing. Is that John Murray back?
He's back, yeah. I'm really living a life right, doing everything I can, give myself the best possibility of going over there. And, they say that world title fights can change your life, and I think this could be the one. You know, win this fight and it's going to change my life forever. So I'm putting everything into it, and like I say, I want to give myself the best opportunity of going over there and winning this fight, and I think that I've done that. He's a very, very good fighter. He'll come forward, he can punch, very aggressive. But we've watched him, we've watched tapes of him. These are the fights that I want to be involved in. I've always done well against fighters that stand in front of me, and I don't see it's being any different. We're preparing ourselves to be in the best shape we can possibly be in to fight Brandon Rios, and I'm ready. I just want to go over there and do what I do, and I'm worrying about getting myself into the top shape I can be in, and letting him worry about me. I'm not too worried about him.